In this video, I am going to explain three big reasons why you should stop toasting Naija babes. And I'm going to explain the actual way to do it, the actual way to get with a girl in 2021. So keep watching. Number one, it doesn't take more than two encounters for a girl to know if she is attracted to you or not. One very big mistake a lot of us guys make, especially Naija guys, is thinking that you have to put in too much effort to get a girl. That's something that we kind of grow up with. You be man, so now you supposed to toast babe, or now you supposed to strike babe. No, not be so. You see, women don't need that much to know if they like somebody. I promise you, right? If babe see you, like you, the effort you need to put in will be very minimal. All these statements you hear from a lot of women where they are like, he has to put in effort to get me, blah, 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 is just a trap.
Like, you also can ask people that dated me. I'm the hardest to catch. Forget this my smile, we are smiling on the internet. Don't ask questions. It's not easy chilling with me.
That's what she uses to trap simps. Women want to have side guys. Women want to have orbiters. You understand? But there will always be one or two guys that they truly like. You understand? Guys maybe say go demand for anything, the girl go give them. I'm telling you, every woman has one or two of those guys that she truly is attracted to. The remaining are just guys where she they use chop. Guys wish they use commode. If you know everything she do for house, guys wish they use chill, flex. That's what those guys are. And you don't want to be those guys. You don't. Initial attraction can happen between you and a girl when she sees you or when you guys talk. But it doesn't take time. The only thing that takes time is long-term attraction. To know if you want to be with somebody, you know, in the long term, you know, as a girlfriend or as a wife, whatever. That's the only thing that takes time. But you see that initial attraction, but if babe see you head to toe, if babe look you head to toe when I talk, she knows there and then whether 12 and I go feel knack. That's just the fact. You understand? So all that extra effort you're putting, do they spend months, 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, they chide babe, in get guy, BBC, in use only 1 week, top them talk, top them already they knack. I'm telling you. Now obviously everything is not about getting her into bed, but relationships are honestly S3X oriented. You're not going to come out and be like, no be everything be knacks. Truly, no be everything be knacks. But if she's willing to give one guy in 1 week and not give you in 8 months, you know they understand. I'm not seeing the psychology behind that. She will keep on creating rules for you. The guy who is trying and putting in effort, she's going to give you step. In go day like game. When you pass level one, then level two, then level three, then level four. For a guy who she likes, immediately when she meet him, after 1 to 2 weeks, she has already taken him to level 10. He does not need to play the game the way you play the game because he understands what attraction is. If babe like you, she like you. If she don't like you, just leave him. You get? If a girl doesn't like you, it's not a bad thing. Like, not every girl is going to find you attractive. If she doesn't like you, there's no issue. Eh? Where problem go there now? If you can't take the hint and walk away, that's where the problem is. If you notice that she's not feeling you, leave for your own peace of mind. The second reason why toasting babes is pointless is that the more unreciprocated effort you put in, the less she will respect you. In simple terms, the more you invest in her and she doesn't invest in you, and you keep on investing in her, the more she will look at you like, what did they do this guy? Like, what's your problem? Do you have a life? Do you have any goals in this life for you to be pedestalizing me like this? Do you understand? There's one subconscious thing about us human beings. It's not even just babes, though. Even us as guys. You reason now. Like, if somebody is just flattering you for nothing, they are complimenting you, you know, anything you want, they'll give. For nothing, you're not investing anything into them. You said your body could do you somehow. Like what is all this? You said you feel it's fake. You feel it is fake. It will feel very ungenuine. That's how these women feel too. If they call them 7 times a week, you know they call you once. Even once, you know they call you. But you keep on calling. It's cringe. It's cringe to her. Like, what am I doing for this guy, right? For him to give me all this effort and interest. It feels so fake. Which is why in general, women are attracted to bad boys, quote unquote. Because they're not trying that hard. Even if they tell you, hey, I like you, right? Once they tell you, they don't come out. If you know they're interested, they go leave you. So women will chase men like that. Because it's more, first of all, it's attractive to them. But it's also genuine. You know, but they invest in person when they invest back. That's how human beings are supposed to work. So when you're not working like that, she's looking at you like something they do this guy. If you treat her like a queen, she'll treat you like a fan. The third reason why toasting babes is stupid is that you're wasting money, time, and resources that could go to your business, that could go to your path or your future, or even to a girl who actually likes you. You're wasting it on somebody who is not interested in you. It doesn't make any sense to me. Now, the big question is, how do you fix this problem that comes with toasting? Like, how do you fix this problem? How do you get into an actual relationship the right way? And the answer is simple. The first step is understanding signals, right? Girls that like you most likely will give you signals. Right, they will break the touch barrier faster. They would want to, person will just meet you today, don't they hold your hand, don't they tell you, you're funny. That's a signal. those little signals are what you should follow. You need to wait for those signals first before you make a move. You know, you see guys maybe say, guys when they walk out for road, maybe say they could just see one girl, the girl makes sense, they go meet and collect her number. Bro, do you understand that 70 to 80 guys are doing that same exact thing to that girl? You reason say not only you they collect, or you reason say you they special? No, now you see that cold approach. Cold approach is the biggest way to waste your time as a man. You see random girl for road, you go meet and collect her number. Guy, she already puts you like mentally, but even if on a normal day she could have liked you, once you just do that thing, she has already put you in like a group of guys already that she's not going to reason. Guys, maybe like she has a group in her head. Maybe say she no favor reason. She don't put you inside that group. Once you do that, right? So you need to be able to put yourself in more social situations, more social environments, whether in a church, whether in a school, events, right? It is in those situations now that you know who and who is feeling you. Do you understand? Then you can now make the move. Now, when you make the move, right, and you notice that she's interested, you have to know that she's interested. If that interest, no, the senior man, whiz. If she's not ready to invest back into you by maybe calling, you understand? Just putting in some effort. If you need to put in effort, whiz. Okay. So she's putting in effort now, right? For example, the next step now is letting her know what your values are, like the things you will take from a woman and the things you won't take. Now, you won't verbally tell her. You don't need to verbally tell her. But whenever she steps out of line, she does something that you feel like is wrong, right? Don't be insulted. Don't be rude. But let her know, right? Let her know that, like, you can't take stuff like this, right? And after letting her know, don't be scared of walking away, which is if you let her know and she insults you or she keeps on doing it, don't be scared of leaving. That's one big mistake guys make. If she don't too fuck up, leave her, right? Leaving her, most probably she might even come back. But if you're scared of leaving a woman who is doing something wrong to you, you're going to be in an unhealthy relationship. So that's just the blueprint. Instead of toasting random people on the road, the first thing you should do is check for signals. Should they give me signal? Two, make sure she's investing in you. Investing no means saying she they send you money per se, but like her time, my G, being able to call, being able to know how you're doing. Not be everything be me. I want this, I want that. She has to care what you want, qua. It's a relationship and there should be some type of balance. Letting her know that you have boundaries and making sure that she follows those rules. If she doesn't follow those rules, then you whiz. That's how to interact with women. This whole over-validating, over-investing. Now, we think they make men, they relationships where they say their wife, they sleep with another man. She's sleeping with a man who is more masculine than you are. That's what she's doing. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel and you like more dating related videos, definitely hit the subscribe button. Also, I think the next video you should watch is the one that just popped up on the screen. The name is Why High Value Men or Why Rich Men Suffer in Relationships. Watch that video and I'll see you guys in the next one. It go be.